Hi there, I'm Mike Gales for Fight Your Way Fit, and if you like these videos and you also like reading articles, then please check me out at fightyourwayfit.com. There, I have tons of written articles that just may help you achieve your fitness goals a little more quickly. So please come on over and visit. In this video, I wanted to do a quick review of the basic punches of boxing in under 10 minutes. This way, if you're new to this type of training, you can use this video along with the other videos that are listed in the description below to put together some phenomenal workouts. And you're gonna find that this type of training is the absolute best to get yourself into fantastic shape. So first off, where to begin? Well, let's learn your basic boxing stance. Assuming a proper boxing stance will give you a biomechanical advantage in generating more power for your punches. It will also help with economy of motion so that you can increase your stamina, and it also increases your defensive capabilities by covering up soft targets like your ribcage and chin. So how to stand? Sounds easy enough. Well, you don't want to be standing all square in front of your opponent like this, as your punches will have very little leverage, and you'll have a lot of your body exposed to a direct line of fire from your opponent. So instead, you will want to angle your lead shoulder towards the center of your opponent to make yourself a smaller target by cutting off the angle of your opponent's attack. Also, being at an angle will help you make use of the rotational movements of your core. But angle yourself which way? Well, the first question that you need to ask yourself is, are you right-handed or left-handed? You will want to keep your dominant foot and hand to the rear. That way, if you get pinned up in close quarters against your opponent, you are not stuck defending yourself with your weaker arm. Also, force is equal to mass multiplied by acceleration, and you want to keep enough distance between your more powerful arm and the target. That means that if you're right-handed, you will want to keep your right leg and arm to the rear. And if you are left-handed, well then you are going to want to keep your left leg and arm to the rear. Now that you have your dominant leg and arm to the rear, you will want to make sure that your legs are not together in a straight line like so, as that will leave you off balance and vulnerable to getting knocked over. So move the rear leg away from you and keep your legs diagonally apart, just a little wider than shoulder width. Also notice that I keep my rear heel up. Doing that will allow me to really push off of the floor to generate more power for my punches, and it will also allow me to increase my mobility. I also have my hands up. Now please notice that I not only raise up my arms, I also simultaneously raise up my shoulders, and I brought my head down just a touch. So that way I can use my shoulders to really protect my chin. Even though I have my hands and my shoulders up nice and high for defense, I'm not blocking my vision, and I can still see clearly.
Next up, let's learn the most important punch in all of boxing. The jab.
The jab is a straight punch that is thrown from the lead arm only, and it is the punch that is most often used in boxing. The reason for that is because it's the quickest punch that you can throw, as it has the least distance to travel to make contact with your opponent. It is also the safest punch that you can throw, as you can still remain relatively covered up as you jab from a distance. When thrown correctly, the jab doesn't require a huge amount of energy either. It can be used offensively to set up punches and create openings, or defensively to stop an opponent's attack or create distance. To throw the jab, you will assume your proper boxing stance. Remember to have your lead shoulder angled towards the center of your opponent. Keep your hands up, keep those shoulders up. Remember to keep your chin down, but have your eyes up and looking at your opponent. Keep your feet diagonally apart and keep your rear heel up. When your jab is extended, you should see your arm almost straight. Notice that if your elbow is kicked out to the side like so, this will make your punch slower, limit the reach of the punch, and drastically reduce the power of the jab, as there's really not any body weight behind the shot. Instead, you will want to generate the maximum amount of power for your jab by having the fist, wrist, elbow and shoulder all traveling along the same plane towards the target like so. Another thing to notice is that you do not want to throw your jab leaving your face totally exposed. So try your best to ensure that your shoulder comes up high enough to protect your chin as you throw your jab. Also try to ensure that the rear hand stays up as high as comfortably possible to protect your head and that the rear elbow is kept in close to the body to protect your rib cage. If the jab is thrown in place, then the power of the jab will come from a slight internal rotation of your hip and core. Notice that I'm still in my boxing stance, and because my rear heel is up, I can generate force with my legs to rotate my hips and put some power behind that jab. For a jab to the body, you don't want to be reaching down, as that will limit your reach and leave your face totally exposed. Instead, you're going to want to switch levels by bending at the legs so that you can still throw your jab in a straight line. More often than not, you will use your jab in conjunction with a step
close the distance towards your target. Using these tips will help you develop a great jab, which every boxer should have within their toolbox.
Next on the menu, we're going to learn how to throw a cross.
The cross is a straight punch that is thrown from the rear hand only. It is a power punch that has a trajectory that goes straight across the body from the rear hand right towards its intended target, hence the name cross. Because there is sufficient distance from the target, a boxer is capable of putting a lot of their mass directly into their cross, and as such is probably the hardest punch that you can throw. The cross is thrown from your proper boxing stance, and the power from the cross starts with the legs. You will use your rear foot to push off of the floor, and then follow through by rotating your leg, hip, and core into the shot as you extend the punch out in a straight line. You are using that rotation of your body to transfer weight from the rear leg and drive all of your weight forward, putting momentum into the punch. The harder that you can push off of the floor with that rear foot to rotate and swivel your legs and core, the more powerful your punch is going to be. As with the jab, do not throw the cross like this, leaving your face totally exposed. As best you can, try and keep your rear shoulder up high to protect your chin as you throw your cross. Remember to have your lead shoulder angled towards the center of your opponent. Keep your hands up, keep your shoulders up. Remember to keep your chin down, but have your eyes up looking at your opponent with your feet diagonally apart to maintain your balance. As you throw the punch, try and keep your lead hand up as high as comfortably possible for defense. Many beginners will also have their elbow flare out to the side like so. Throwing the punch like that will lead to having very little power. Instead, you'll want to keep that elbow in closer to your body so that as much of your mass as possible is traveling in a straight plane directly towards your target. Your final hand position should see your fist, wrist, elbow, and shoulder almost in a straight line. Now let's take a look at a cross to the body. Well, just like throwing the jab to the body, you will want to switch levels. You don't want to be reaching down, leaving your face exposed. So switch levels to throw a cross to the body by bending your legs to get down low, either to the body or to the face. All of the power for your cross comes from the rotation of your legs, hips, and core.
So my friends, let's keep going. Now we're going to learn how to throw a hook.
A hook is a punch that is thrown in an arc to get around the defense of your opponent. You can think of it in a way where the end result is not having your arm extended in a straight line, but your arm is bent, resembling a hook, sort of like the ones that you use when you go fishing. Most people try and throw a hook like this, where they just wail and flail their arms all over the place. These shots have little to no power. The real secret to throwing the hook is to put your whole body weight behind it by using the rotation of your legs and core. Notice here that my arm isn't even really moving. Now that you're going to put your whole body behind your punch, let's take a look at your hand position. Hold your hand directly in front of you, then bend it so it forms a 90-degree angle. Notice that your palm is facing you. The muscles of your forearm will keep your wrist much more stable when your palm is facing towards you. Notice here as I throw my hooks that my palm is facing me and my arm is not really moving all that much. It's the rotation of my body that creates the power. Like when you throw the jab and a cross, remember that you don't want to leave your head exposed. So keep your shoulders high and your chin down low. Remember to keep the hand and the shoulder that's not being used to throw the punch up. Again, you want to throw your hook from your proper boxing stance with your feet diagonally apart. To throw a powerful hook has very little to do with your arms. You will want to use your whole body to transfer as much weight as possible into your hook. To get into the practice of really rotating my hips, I used to visualize myself sort of squashing out a cigarette butt on the floor with my foot. So to reiterate, the hook is a power punch, and that power punch starts with your feet, then your legs, hips, and core. Then all of that rotational force is delivered through your arm and your hand towards the intended target. Let's take a look at a hook to the body. It may not be feasible to switch levels in close quarters to throw a hook. Just notice that as I throw these hooks to the body, that my shoulder is still kept up high enough to protect my chin. Either to the body or to the head, the power for your hooks comes from the rotation of your legs, hips, and core. Not only will using those muscles help increase the power of your hook, they will also take much longer to fatigue than simply using the smaller muscles of your arm.
The final basic punch in boxing that you're going to need to know is how to throw an uppercut.
Let's throw an uppercut. First off, what is an uppercut? Well, it's a power punch that penetrates the opponent's defenses by coming from underneath and then upwards towards its intended target. It can also be a devastating shot because it's difficult to see coming. Because it arrives at a different angle, your opponent will have to alter their defenses to block it. Thus, the uppercut is a tricky little shot. The uppercut is thrown from your proper boxing stance, with your feet diagonally apart. Contrary to how most people throw it using only their arm, the power of the uppercut comes from using your legs and the muscles of your core. Notice here that I generate force for my uppercut by using my legs to push off of the ground. I then rotate my hips and core in an upward motion to drive my fist towards the intended target. Let's take a look at your hand position. When you hold your arm straight out in front of you and then bend it towards your body, you'll notice that your palm is almost facing you. It's in this position, when your palm is facing you, that the muscles supporting your wrist will be at their strongest, and that will leave you less susceptible to injuries. You can see from the side view that I use my body to transfer as much weight as possible into my shot. Remember to keep the other hand that is not throwing the punch up high for protection. Let's take a look at an uppercut to the body. Throw the uppercuts to the body in the same fashion as you did to the head. It is not feasible to switch levels. Simply angle your shoulder and arm so that the punch now lands a little lower on your opponent. Notice that even though I'm angling these uppercuts towards my opponent's body, that my shoulders are still high enough to protect my chin, and that will limit my exposure to being hit by a counter shot. So one last time, I'll reiterate that the real power for the uppercut comes not simply from the motion of the arm, but from the upward motion of your legs, hips, and core.
There you have it. You now know everything that you need to know to use along with the videos that are listed in the description below. And you can use those workouts to get yourself into great shape. As always, I thank you for taking the time to watch, and please come on over and check me out at fightyourwayfit.com.